in reverse. And Liza Minnelli is going on the record with Greta. That best of the rest and last call all just minutes away. Thank you so much. Great to see you. Well, coming up, what else can we say? Liza Minnelli goes on the record with Greta. The legend talks about her new DVD and shares some stories about Sinatra, paparazzi, and even more up next. Plus, the prank
on the record with Shannon Bream tonight. Thanks for watching Fox News Channel.
Now, one of the biggest stars ever goes on the record with Greta, Liza Minnelli. She was just nominated for a Grammy for Liza's at the Palace. You can catch that event on DVD on February 2nd. Greta talked to Liza about that and, of course, got some behind-the-scenes old-school Hollywood stories.
Liza, nice to see you.
Hey, Greta, how you doing?
I'm really well. This is exciting for me, and, of course, I feel so Hollywood, these big chairs. We don't usually get to sit in chairs like these.
Oh, good.
this is
comfortable.
It is quite comfortable.
Oh, yeah, it's good.
All right, first of all, the headband. You got a headband on. What's that with the headband?
I'm going to rehearsal after I finish with you.
Your work.
Yeah, how's that?
All right, there's big news. You have a DVD coming out in February, and it's nominated for a Grammy, so tell us about this DVD.
Well, it's the show that we won the Tony for, and it's the second act, and the first act is stuff I don't think that you've heard. There's some Asavore things and some very interesting acting choices on it. And the second half is all about my godmother, Kay Thompson.
Who's Kay Thompson?
She was a force, an underground force in Hollywood. First of all, she had a huge radio show. She had vocal singers, and she arranged music like nobody else. Then MGM hired her before she was 30 to run the entire vocal arrangement thing at MGM. Right? That's unheard of. Then, she did, you know, the next little thing she did, is she did, Eloise. Just a little something. Kay Thompson's Eloise.
About the Plaza Hotel?
Yes. Then she did all kinds of things. But what I'm celebrating is the nightclub act that she did in 1948. And I saw it. I was two, but I saw it. And I remember it. The stage came up about here, right? And what I remember is, what I'm seeing on Mom's lap across from my dad are these feet that just never stop moving, and these long arms, and this, and the audience roaring with laughter, because she was truly witty.
All right, okay, let's talk about this Grammy Award.
Oh, my God.
Are you nervous?
Yes.
Wow, you won every other award. Why?
Well, I always get nervous.
You got some competition. I mean, Michael Bublé and Tony Bennett. Those are
two of my favorite singers in the world.
But look at the competition you had for the Oscar. You had Diana Ross. I mean, the competition they had then when you won your Oscar. So you faced hard competition before.
But Tony Bennett, I have every album he ever made, and then all the CDs. I mean, I used to get a bus ticket to go and see him if he was in Brooklyn. I worshipped him, and Bublé, I adore. So those two, I'm up against some pretty stiff competition, but I'm thrilled to be in that company.
Is it really fun and exciting to get out there and sing these songs, or does it work for you?
No
to both of those?
It's fun and it's exciting because the audience that I'm singing to has never seen me before. Or if they have, I can always find a face that's never seen me. I can always find somebody who's doing this, you know. And then I perform the whole show for that person. They don't know it. But I don't get off stage until I get them.
All right, so last night I listened to all these tapes of you on YouTube. In addition, I've seen this DVD. I've got an advance of the one that you nominated for this Grammy. And the one that keeps popping up is New York, New York.
Oh, thank you.
And what is it? You mean there's one with you and Sinatra. Tell me what it's like singing with Sinatra.
Do that show with Sammy and Frank? See, they would have loved the Kay Thompson show because they worshipped her. They worshipped Kay. I can't tell you what they thought of her. We used to spend hours on planes talking about her. But it was great because it was really simple. Wherever Frank went, Sammy and I went the other way and made it work. You know?
What was Frank like?
Frank is great. was Greta. Anyways, Rachel, it was always wonderful to me, and that's all I can go by.
All right. The other end of the spectrum, which I thought was fascinating, is that I heard a music video with you and Pavarotti singing New York, New York.
Yes.
Now, that seemed like to me, I mean, of course, that's the one I immediately clicked on because it seemed the most unusual.
Yes, it was.
I don't know. How did that come about?
He wanted to sing it. And it was his show, and it was for charity. So I said, okay, you know. And so I guess there's not a lot of rhythm in the opera. Because if you watch that tape, he was so brilliant. Watch the tape. When we rehearsed it the first time, he went, "Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of this." I said, "No, wait. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today." So I didn't know how to make this work. So I get on stage with him. He goes, "My little town blues." I went, yeah. Anything to get those beats in there. You just make it work.
Why is it that you can all stay on top for so long? What is it? Is it hard work, or is it talent, or it's a little luck, or what is it?
I think it's got to be both. I mean, don't you? It's got to be caring about what you do. I mean, you do research on people. You're great at what you do.
Yeah, but you've stayed on top forever. I mean, you've had, like, enormous success.
Well,
everybody knows Liza Minnelli.
Yeah, but I never changed my name to Garland. I'm my father's daughter, too. My father was a brilliant director and a great, great scenic designer. He designed all the sets for Radio City Music Hall. And then all the movies he made. So I was always around. And I learned. And then I only work with people I can learn from. I don't need yes people. I don't like them. I want to learn. That's all I want to do. That's what keeps me going. And if you're curious, you can't get depressed. You can't get angry. You don't get a lot of time for yourself if you're curious. And if you stay that way. And that's my job.
One of the things that I think was the beginning of your career, at least when people got to know you, was when you introduced on television the great movie The Wizard of Oz. When it first appeared on TV, you introduced it.
How old was I?
10.
Oh, I don't remember at all.
Okay, all right. Yeah, I said one question. Did you ever meet Margaret Hamilton?
Oh, yeah.
What was she like? Because she was the meanest witch. She's horrible. Was she nice in person?
My sister, Laura, is doing a lot of that now. She's doing it great.
But what was Margaret Hamilton like?
She was the nicest lady ever met.
She certainly didn't seem it.
No, but that's the movies.
All right, because they have Margaret Hamilton, that scene on the bicycle, which is going past the house.
Oh, my God, wasn't that scary?
That was terrible. That was the worst thing I've ever seen. It looked like every bad music teacher ever had, though, I might add. That's probably
the one
say that, probably.
Only one story that I know that I remember was that in one of those things with a puff of smoke and Margaret Hamilton disappears, there was a trap door, right? And she went down that. And something went wrong with the explosion, something, and she caught a fire. So they had to come and put her out.
But that's what killed her in the end. That's what killed her in the end. The water.
Oh my God!
Yes. I take it that winning the Grammy, because you've had so many awards, that you want to win this one for Kate Thompson. I sort of got that. Is that a little bit of it?
A lot. It would mean the world to me. And she was the most important person in my world, thanks to my parents.
There is so much more Greta's interview with Liza Minnelli. You can check it all out